So a lot of people will say to me, all right, Mike, so you have this kind of crazy job where you have these adventures where you're racing the clock to put an experiment out and try not to kill anyone with a boat, or you're... experiment gets attacked by some vicious predator. You catch octopus stealing your cameras. You high-five adorable sea turtles when you're on your way to your field sites. You compete in half-naked fruit stick races. But is this your job every day? What is your job actually like? This is actually a really good question, because there is more to being a marine biologist than going out in the field and having adventures while you're doing field research. Of course, to do that field research, you have to plan out that research, and maybe even more importantly than that, you've got to get funding to do said research. So, for all the crazy adventures and exciting encounters that I have that I get to tell you guys about on my YouTube channel here, for all of that time, there is a tremendous amount of time behind those adventures that allow those adventures to happen. And that time comes in the form of writing grants and reading and writing about science, publishing papers about the studies that I'm telling you guys about. Because without doing all those things, I wouldn't be able to go out into the field and have these adventures. So my life in particular, and I'm just one marine biologist, I'm just one person, so it's variable depending on who you talk to, but just so you have an idea on what it can be like, I finished my PhD last year, I'm starting a postdoc fellowship now, and for the past 6 years, and for the upcoming 2 years, I'll be living life in a similar way. And the way that works is, I typically spend 2 to 4 months out of the year working in the field, collecting new data, and I get these data from field studies and field experiments, so I can go out and collect information on the habitat in an undisturbed setting, or I can impose an experimental manipulation and isolate specific effects that are interesting to me, which typically for me involve how humans affect ecosystems so that we can better understand how to manage these systems for the future. So the other 8 to 10 months of the year, I am not having adventures in remote corners of the world, but I am instead on a campus working on grants and working on publications about that work. I've learned that you have to actually be a pretty effective salesperson to be a successful scientist. Because remember, you can't do any of this stuff. You can't go out there and have those adventures unless you've convinced someone that those ideas are worthy of funding. Will exploring your ideas fill needed gaps in human knowledge? Will it be useful to society? Because without funding, you're not flying to French Polynesia and spending 3 months there. Another significant part of my time commitment is to teaching, which I sometimes do on campus and sometimes I do in the field, bringing students out to these remote locations and teaching them firsthand what science is actually like. My personal favorite. So, understand, there is exciting, amazing adventure that is available in this job, in being a marine biologist. Adventure that you probably can't have in other occupations, but remember, that is just a fraction of what you do throughout the time of your career. I actually love those 8 to 10 months when I'm not out in the field in this really intense environment, because that gives me time to think really carefully and critically about what I want to do next and plan that out in a really effective way and in a convincing way that seems to, up to this point anyway, have been successful in getting me funding. So for science, as it turns out, it's not mo money, mo problems. It's mo money, mo awesome. You know what would feel amazing for you right now? Subscribing, watching more videos, and sharing all this with people that you love.